Hi, I'm Mejdi Max, and I'm here to share a lip art inspired by the humble but delightful ladybug. Or ladybird, if you're across the pond. I started with a velvety matte lip, and then created some daisies for the ladybird to feast on. And then I just couldn't resist, and decided to cover my lips in rhinestones as usual. So let the madness begin. I began by priming my lips with MAC Prep and Prime Lip Base. Then I sunk my trowel into the Makeup Forever Waterproof Lip Pencil in 8C and drew on a lip shape, pointed and overdrawn, as I like to do. Next, I took the Lime Crime Velveteen in Suede Berry and smeared that over the center of my lips. I smushed them together to pat down the soil, and then took out my favorite red lipstick, the Kat Von D Everlasting Liquid Lipstick in Outlaw. I tilled that deep around the edges of my lips, laying down a fertile ground. Skipping back to Suede Berry, I applied more in the center and blended that through with my lips. Now for a velvety touch, I've grabbed the Sugar Pill Pro Palette and dipped into Flame Point to pat that over the center, giving a luscious texture and a pouty look. I dug that fluffy eyeshadow brush into Love Plus by Sugar Pill as well and patted that around the edges. Now for some sticky situations. I used the Ever Amicable Prosade and dotted on a central point so I can attach this yellow rhinestone as the central disc. Of course, I'm using my Embelly Jelly stick, which is invaluable for picking up these pesky little stones. I created another flower on my top lip with the clear elliptical rhinestones. The weird thing about daisies are they are actually composite flowers, and each petal itself is yet another flower. So those simple little flowers are rather complicated and kind of messed up. Now for a bit of stability, I am creating the stem and petals using some even smaller green rhinestones. I prod the stones down with the end of the Embelly Jelly stick to scooch them into place, pressing them down with the tip of my finger. This is kind of like pixel art, and if you think of it like a computer game, it kind of makes more sense. Using a pointed cotton bud helps with getting just the right amount of glue on the lips. Now I'm deciding how to create the ladybug feature. It's a feature, not a bug. I got a little ahead of myself and a little too funky, and tried to create a ladybug out of the rhinestones. After a few attempts on the back of my hand and trying one on my lips, I didn't like the way it looked, so I just picked that stuff off. It doesn't work every time. I did a bit of surgery with more liquid lipsticks and the eyeshadows. And now we can get back to the fun stuff. So I'm using this ever so cute ceramic ladybug and I'm attaching it with the Prosade. First I smear some Prosade on the ladybug's butt and then I stamp it onto my lip where I want it affixed. Now I'm just letting it dry, fanning it with my hand and this Lit Cosmetics glitter fan. Once the glue has become translucent, it will adhere nice and tough. So I'm placing the ladybug where I want it and holding it on for a few seconds while it dries. I liked the way the lip looked with the supple matte background and the shiny adornments on top. However, I wasn't quite satisfied, so I dug back into the Prosade and started smearing that all over my lips. I used some rather chunky red rhinestones of about 4mm even down to 3 and 2mm sizes, basically cramming them so they covered my entire lips. I used the larger ones around the edges, and once I ran out of those, I moved on to these self-adhesive ones that are not quite as nice looking, but they still get the job done. They're just kind of a bitch to manipulate because you have to pick them off the sticky back and then try and cram them on your lips. I much prefer the loose ones in the rhinestone wheels. I used some red elliptical rhinestones to slot in between the petals of the flowers so that I could get as much coverage of a red sparkly stuff all over the place. This lip could have done with a glitter backing under the rhinestones, because it's always good to have an extra sparkle as a background for any nooks and crannies that don't get covered by the rhinestones. I went about my merry way, plowing along my lips with my trowel and spade tools of the trade. And when I decided I had crammed on just enough red reflection, I'm done. A ladybug deserves to frolic in a twinkling meadow of rhinestones every now and again. So I took this little guy off my amp and stuck it to my face. Luckily, the Prozaid comes off nicely, and his butt did not remain sticky. I have to thank Heather Morehouse for giving me a tingle for the ladybird, reminding me I had this cute little ceramic guy lying around. Check out her makeup tutorial, linked in the description box. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this festive garden scene on my lips, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos. And if you want to send me a letter or something, I have my PO box in the description box.